All right, back again for another breakdown. Decided just to do a single goal here. It's a little quicker and easier. Looking forward to the season starting. That way I can break down more games. But let's take a look at what we got here. So let's go back and watch this in slow motion. So power play. So when I evaluate a goal, typically, especially when it's in zone, there's usually somewhere that the play gets broken down within like 5 to 10 seconds of the goal happening, where that's where the error is. And so for me, there's two things I see. The first is that this puck down low is not dangerous. Now, Anderson goes into the RVH. There's no reason to go in the RVH. He can't score here. This guy's not really a danger. Not sure who's up top. You can't see with the screen. But he goes into the RVH, goes post to post. So now he's on his knees. So he has to adjust. Now there are options. This guy's creeping in. This guy can step and shoot. This guy can step and pass. Or he can go high. So think about this. Is it harder or easier to move when you're on your knees? It's harder. So now he's down. So he gets to seals a short side like he should. Good. He has a good stick. He's following the puck. Now, this is where breakdown number two is. Because he's on his knees, he can't see that pass, so he makes a late recovery and he doesn't square up all the way to the shooter. He squares up more down the middle, and that shooter releases the puck from the inside where he's square down the middle. Oh, three things. And because of that, let's see. Not too happy with his elbow. I would like a little more internal rotation of the elbow as it comes up, but quick shot, not much you can do with the elbow. But because of how the play broke down here, and all because he initiated that RVH too early, now he has to get caught puck watching, excuse me. He's not able to take a head check and see that 65's high. He's not able to recover exactly to 65. So he recovers to the middle and he gets beat. So usually when you watch these things, it's never just like a black and white thing. Something breaks down early on in the play. In this situation, it was just improper timing of the RVH. Now, again, like it's easy for me to sit here in my armchair and make my opinion. But for younger kids watching, if you don't have to go into the RVH, don't. If the puck's below the goal line, like in this situation, it's not dangerous. Just hold your feet, go post to post on your feet, then quick head check, see what's around. Then if this player steps out, you can go into the RVH, seal the short side, or you can make your move and square up properly to the guy in front of you.